Hey, what's up, and welcome back to Interpreting the Stars, where today we are taking a look at Rocketman, which is a 2019 biographical drama that's in part the true life story of Elton John, but also in part a fun little discography musical, which in a way is kind of the first of its kind. You have Mamma Mia, you have Across the Universe, those are discography musicals, but they don't tell the true life story of the artist that they're using for their music. This does, and I can't get enough of it. It actually surprised me because I thought it was gonna be basically a Bohemian Rhapsody, but Elton John. But where Freddie Mercury made music with Queen, Elton John lived and breathed music as a form of escape to get away from his destructive lifestyle. Because without music, he didn't really even know who he was. He had an abusive upbringing. People couldn't accept him. He used drugs and alcohol as a clutch. And the greatest thing is this movie didn't shy away from that. Elton John kept this movie in back burner for years because people wanted to make it PG-13. And he was like, I didn't live a PG-13 life. So he waited until he could make the movie because he's not gonna bow down to censorship gods, which is one of the greatest things about this movie. By avoiding those censorship gods, he was able to make this raw and real and believable, even though it is a musical that feels like a musical and is a lot of fun at the same time. It does a really, really good job of blending different tones together in a way that makes sense and is acceptable and is welcoming to watch and is just a joy to experience as a whole. At first, I didn't really understand the casting choice for Taron Egerton, or whatever his name is, but I do now. He does such a wonderful, awesome job in this role. He's the best thing about this movie. There are times in this movie where I was like, did they blend him with the real Elton John with some de-aging magic done on his face? Is that what they did? Because he looks the part, he also sounds the part. Some of the singing doesn't sound exactly the same, but I think that's because Elton John coached him into not sounding exactly like him, to be his own person, to play his own role. Because it is slightly fictional when it comes down to how things worked out. Obviously, people don't just start dancing with you, even though you might want to when you listen to Elton John music. I was watching this with my 4-year-old who always wanted to get up off the couch and start dancing whenever one of these tunes started playing, because that's how you feel when you watch it. You just feel happy and giddy. Even if you aren't the biggest fan of Elton John, I know not everybody is, and that's how it was. My son wanted to dance to it, and I was just sitting there with a smile on my face watching it because it was just a joy to watch in general. That's the two main positives that I want to say about this movie, is that it makes you feel good when you watch it. It stayed true to the general tone, the general gist of what made Elton John Elton John. It stayed true to a lot of things. The performances were really phenomenal. This movie is actually kind of a coming of age film because Elton definitely had a dependent personality. He was always depending on alcohol, on drugs, on other people, instead of depending on himself, instead of loving himself. So throughout this film, it's definitely going in the direction of Elton trying to find a spot in life where he can find happiness independently of others. As I said in a couple of my most recent reviews, I'm not a huge fan of coming of age because of story progression specifically. There's very little of it. It just follows around these characters pretty blindly as they do things and learn things about life. So there is character progression, there is character development, just not story. They're not trying to do anything specific, and I don't think that's the main reason you watch this movie. You watch it for the performances, you watch it for the fun musical numbers, you watch it for the heart of the film, and there's a lot of heart in it. There's actually not a ton that I can complain about in this movie. I mean, sure, the story progression, like I said before, but everything else isn't bad. If anything at all, it's typical, it's standard, it's not as good as it could be, but it's not bad. Like, for instance, the characters. Obviously, Elton John shines above the rest. The other characters don't feel like they're as memorable as Elton John. It doesn't mean they're bad characters, but it does mean that I don't give it full points, but I do give it 3 out of 4. It's things like that that kept the score from being any higher than it already is. In general, I really enjoyed this movie, and I think most people who watch it probably will as well, unless they really truly hate Elton John. Something I don't really understand completely, but then again, I'm not a huge fan of Prince, so if they made the same kind of movie about Prince, I wouldn't watch it. Take that as you will. What did I score this? 89%. 89 out of 100 possible stars. If you're curious about where that ranks in my 2019 movies overall, fourth place. It's tied with Netflix's The Perfection, which is a completely different kind of movie, and they're both good in their own regards. But yeah, that's where it's placed, in fourth place for the year, which is pretty good in general for a true story, kind of true story. Really high for biographical, really high for musical, it's really high for everything. Which means that the movie in general impressed me. It did a wonderful job in pretty much all regards. Guys, if you haven't seen it, check it out. If you have, let me know what you thought of it in the comments down below. As for YouTube, you know what to do. Subscribe to me, hit that like button, and hit that bell to be notified when I come out with my next review. And until then, peace out.